Church. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Sunday Night Live. This is the October edition. Is that right? Am I counting my months correctly? Well, we want to welcome you tonight. We want to encourage you to have fun, worship along with us. You know, hold on a second, folks. You know, this church has been through a lot in the last few weeks, and so if I'm going to be completely transparent with you guys, it was really tough to come up with a set list tonight. Actually, it's been really tough to come up with, like, the songs for Sunday worship lately. Not that God has changed, because he's the same yesterday, today, and forever, but sometimes, you know, we go through different, you know, trials, we go through different, you know, the river is rough, or sometimes the streams are just calm, and that can happen in our lives. So, but God is good all the time. Amen. And all the time. God is good. So we want to invite you all to please stand up and join us this evening. So everybody stand up. And you might notice that the band is a little smaller than usual. We got Jonathan on bass again. Say hi, Jonathan. And we have his other uncle, my cousin-in-law, Carlos, on drums back there. And my wife, Cheeky, and my cousin, Minerva, who's the cousin of that guy. So it's like a whole family thing going on right now. So yeah, welcome everybody tonight. We're going to worship together. One, two, one, two, three, four.
Today is the day you have made. I will rejoice.
are free in him. Amen. All right, can we get the house lights up a little? Yeah, it's kind of a gentle calm there. That's awesome. Well, again, that was awesome. Thank you guys for singing. We want to take a moment right now, something we I think this church is really needing. I want to invite Pastor Tyler and Liz to just kind of come up here real quick. And we're going to take a few minutes right now, and we're going to have a moment of prayer. If you feel like praying out loud, if you want to come up and be prayed over, actually, I want to get, if there are any elders out there who want to come up and just kind of be some prayer leaders, don't be shy. Come on up here. If there's anything going on in your heart, in your life that you need to pray over right now, we want to invite you. We want to take some time and just pray and give this moment to the Lord. So I'm going to be playing a little bit on the piano, and just as the Spirit leads you, come on up and let's just lift up this time to him. Father, as we take some time right now to speak to you, to listen to you, to be vulnerable in front of you, to be at your feet, to lay down at your feet, God. God, I just ask that you help us to quiet our hearts from the busyness of life, from the busyness of every day. Busyness of family, busyness of church, busyness of work. And I pray that you help us, Lord, to hear that still small voice as you speak to us. And if there's anyone out there who needs prayer, we're going to take the time right now. Father, we love you. Father, we thank you for loving us and always being there. Being the same yesterday, today, and forever. We thank you that your love never changes. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank you.
Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. I see a
So we're going to switch things up a little bit. That's because we can do that. We can do that, right? Is that okay? So on the list was another prayer time, and I think we can totally do that. In fact, I would love for you if you were just take a couple of seconds and maybe pray with me and pray for me here. I wanted to share a little bit about just not a testimony really, but just the fact that God has been so faithful and he has been always present, even on those times and days when I know that we all have been there, and I know I've felt like sometimes, man, God, where are you? how come I'm going through this, or how come, you know, they're getting that cool stuff and we're not, and we're struggling here. And but those people, man, I thought I was doing better than those people, but they're succeeding here and there. And I'm thinking to myself, man, I'm so full of myself right now. I'm so thankful that God is like, he can like kind of nudge you and go, stop thinking to yourself. But he's still so nice about it, because he can truly, you know, we've seen in the Bible where God wasn't so like nice about it. You know, he just was kind of getting turned around. But God has been so faithful. And this is a song I just wanted to share. This is, you don't have to sing along. We don't have words, I don't think, unless Felix miraculously found words. That's amazing. This is a song by Stephen Curtis Chapman, and it is called My Redeemer is Faithful and True. It is one of my favorite songs in the universe, and I hope I can even sing it right now, because I get very emotional singing it. So. But it reminds me that no matter where we are, where we think we are right now, when we look back at the story, because, you know, it's not about where you are right now, because sometimes we're so caught up in where we are at this exact moment. You know, there's a bill that we can't pay right away, or there's a thing that we might want, or there's a this and a that that we can't get to. We forget to look back and see how God has taken every single one of those problems, everything that we always thought, wow, we're never going to get through this one. But we're here right now. So clearly God got us through that. So this is what that song reminds me of every single day. So if I start to cry, I need more prayers, because I'm like, I got to get through this. But I hope this song blesses you. Can you hear the guitar okay? As I look back on this road I've traveled, I've seen so many times he's carried me through. But if there's one thing that I've learned in my life, my Redeemer's faithful and true. My Redeemer is faithful. Everything he has said he will do, and every morning his mercies are new. My Redeemer is faithful and true. Do you believe it, church? My heart rejoices when I read the promise. There is a place that I'm preparing for you. I know someday I'll see my Lord face to face. My Redeemer is faithful and true. My Redeemer is faithful and true. Everything he has said he will do. And every morning his mercies are new. My Redeemer is faithful and true. And in every situation, he has proved his love for me. When I lack the understanding, he gives more grace to me. My Redeemer Jesus is faithful and true. Stand up with us one more time. Back to that distortion guitar. Here we go.
My God, how big you are, how big, how big.
sing how great you are. Come on.
My God, how great you are. How great you are.
Sing how great you are.
My God, how great you are. How great you are.
My God, how great. Hear it.
My God, how great you are. How great you
called standing.
Can you hear the voice of the Father inviting you to walk on the water? Risk it all, answer the call, and enter.
Stand.
I keep switching mics, confusing Jake over there. Sorry, Jake. Thank you guys again for coming out tonight. I hope this was a blessing to you. I know that was kind of cleansing for me. Sorry you had to be there for that. But I gotta tell you guys, it is such a blessing to be able to worship with all of you, and I just pray that this is not something that we reserve for Sunday nights or Sunday mornings, that just like in the sermon this morning, that you practice, you listen to God. He may be asking you to go out there and pray over somebody, or he may be speaking a special word to you and just looking to transform your life. Don't be surprised if it happens. We learned about it today during our sermon today, so that was pretty awesome. So we want to leave you tonight with a song that I know that I probably play a lot because I love it. We're just going to sing tonight, all right? Here we go. Come on, Carla. Clap your hands, everybody.
Now is the time for all people from every land to come together. Now is the moment for worship. We enter in with holding nothing. He's worthy, exalted. He's high and lifted up. Sing, sing to the Lord. Open up your heart. Joyful noise in the sanctuary. Sing, sing it to the Lord. Ravish him with love. Let the praises ring in the sanctuary.
Open up your mouth and give him praise. Open up your
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Pastor Tyler, your turn.
Amen. Hey, I love this. This is one of my favorite nights of the month that we do this. Whether it's Kurt's crying or Rejoice throwing a balloon around or Savannah throwing her bear at people, you know, it's just a good night of worship. So we're glad you're all here tonight, and we'll do it again next month. I want to read this verse as a blessing over you as you go. It's Colossians 3, verse 15 through 17. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you were called to peace, and be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Amen?
Amen.
Have a wonderful night.
God bless you. See you on Sunday or Wednesday, group, or other days. We love you.